Ever since Mark Zuckerberg, the CEO of Facebook, announced his company's expansion into the realm of metaverses back in October of 2021, the concept has seemingly not left the lips of many people around the world. And yes, you might be surprised to find out that metaverses were a standalone concept long before Zuckerberg's announcement, specifically since the early 90s. And today, I'll explain to you what metaverse is, the whole concept literally on my five fingers. First, though, welcome to Crypto Finally Explained, the top YouTube channel for crypto education. Here, we explain cryptocurrency topics using different examples, simple analogies, and visual stories. So no matter if you're 5 or 75, you'll be able to understand them. In this video, I'll tell you all about the metaverse. What it is, what does it have to do with crypto, and how is Mark Zuckerberg involved in all of this in the first place? Let's jump right into it. So then, first things first. Let's define the concept of a metaverse, shall we? What is the metaverse? Now, admittedly, you'll find many different definitions of the metaverse online. There are multiple explanations that are much more confusing than helpful. The term itself came from a science fiction novel, Snow Crash, by the American writer Neal Stephenson in 1992. Indeed, Mark wasn't the first genius who came up with it. Even in those days, Neal described the metaverse as a virtual world with virtual real estate. Even the connection to it was made via special goggles, as we call them now, VR glasses. He was describing the whole subculture of quote-unquote avatars who choose to remain connected to metaverse for life by wearing portable terminals. And you know what? Today, this seems to me like the upcoming reality, not fiction. And by the way, a great book, I really recommend it to break your imagination. So, to put it simply, a metaverse is a digital world. The most common examples given revolve around some of the most popular video games today, such as Animal Crossing or Second Life. Within this digital world, you have an avatar and are able to interact with the terrain, items, and other people's avatars around you. When someone talks about metaverses, most individuals will imagine a person with a VR headset on their head. This is because VR tools allow you to be more immersed in the aforementioned digital worlds. In other words, you're able to experience them in 3D. Notice, however, how I use the plural version of the term, metaverses. That's because, honestly, there can be multiple metaverses out there. This is not something that's limited to a one single project or design. Let's go over what users can actually do in a metaverse, and why do we need it? For starters, many individuals imagine metaverses as spaces for new generation gaming. Today, there are already multiple VR-powered gaming options, different activities such as VR saber or mountain climbing, and even cooperative games to play with friends. There's widespread speculation that, in the future, metaverse users will be able to virtually improve their working spaces, arrange meetings with friends or colleagues, visit digital meetup hubs, travel to distant alien lands, and do so much more. It probably wouldn't be too surprising if, in 10 years' time, many of our daily activities, such as shopping, playing games, meeting friends, would be transferred to the metaverse, into a new elusive dimension or reality. That being said, however, when people say the metaverse today, another concept that they are often referring to is a digital world built on blockchain technology. Let's break that down, shall we? A blockchain is an information storage area. You can call it the new age database. Just like you would store your family's photos in an album, blockchains store information. Most of the time, this information relates to cryptocurrency transactions. That's because many blockchains have their own native cryptocurrencies associated with them. Now, I can already hear you asking, what in the world do blockchains have to do with the metaverse? This is so confusing. I can understand your frustration. Worry not though, things are actually much simpler than you think. When I say that the metaverse would be built on blockchain technology, it simply means three things. Number one, the metaverse would be decentralized, at least in some form. Number two, the metaverse would allow you to transact with cryptocurrencies. And number three, your profile information would be stored on the blockchain, the new generation database. Most blockchains are decentralized. What this means is that there is no one central authority overseeing them. The simplest way to imagine it is this. When you go visit a social media platform, your experience will depend on the owners of that platform. The company behind the platform will moderate what you can and cannot see, what you can and cannot say, how you interact with others, and so on. A decentralized version of such a social media platform wouldn't have any of these aforementioned restrictions if the community would decide to not impose them. In other words, decentralized platforms don't have a single ruling authority behind them and depend on the communities to be the decision makers. Within a decentralized metaverse, you would be able to make decisions with the rest of the community in the form of a democratic vote. The well-being of the metaverse would depend on each individual and not some central authority. How cool is that? Now, let's move on to the cryptocurrency transaction question in our new metaverse world. As I've mentioned earlier, most blockchains have their native cryptocurrency. Think of Bitcoin, Ethereum, and the like. If a metaverse would be created with the help of blockchain technology, users would be able to pay for services with the native currency of that blockchain. The simplest way to think of this is the way that you transact with the United States dollar. No matter which US state you might be located in, you will be able to use the same USD with all of your purchases. This is actually even true in many other parts of the world as well. Now, the popular opinion states that Ethereum is the most suitable blockchain for metaverse development. This is because this network is often described as the global computer on which many large projects have already been developed and created. On that note, Ethereum is also often thought to be the foundational network behind Web 3.0, a new form of a decentralized internet. If you're interested to learn more about this topic, I highly encourage you to check out my another explanation video on what is Web3. Before we continue, why is Ethereum better than any other blockchain though? Well, it's scalable, stable, reliable, and most importantly, it was the first blockchain to implement smart contracts. Special automated processes are an automated logic that allows people to make agreements with one another without having to trust if the other party will hold up to their part of the deal. Everything is processed under the openly seen coded logic, and no third parties can affect it from the outside after it was launched. In most cases, even its initial developers can't either. Smart contracts allow for fast, safe, and decentralized transactions to happen on the network. Implemented into the metaverse, they would act in the background. Whether you launch a game or pay for a virtual plot of land, smart contracts would be involved without you even noticing it. Hey, and by the way, if you're enjoying this video so far, a subscription to our channel would be much appreciated. This will help us grow and reach more people, and thus create more educational content about all things crypto. Lastly, let's take a look at the third point, your metaverse personality, a profile of information being stored on the blockchain. Imagine that you'd be able to remain anonymous within the metaverse, thanks to blockchain tech. You'd probably still want to create some sort of a profile though, right? Well, same as you can create a character in a video game, you would also be able to do so within the metaverse, with the help of crypto as well. Your profile would be anonymous, yet tied to your account. Say you've created a digital painting that has become very popular within the metaverse. How do you prove that you were the one who made it? Simple. No matter who owns it now, if it was created, also known as minted, on your profile, you will be forever listed as the creator. This is thanks to the blockchain technology behind the metaverse. Moving on, up to this point in the video, we've discussed what the metaverse is and what cryptocurrencies and blockchain tech have to do with the concept. That's a lot of information to wrap your head around, I'll admit. One big question still remains unanswered though. What does the CEO of Facebook, Mark Zuckerberg, have to do with all of this? As I've mentioned at the beginning of this video, towards the end of October of last year, Zuckerberg announced that Facebook would be rebranding to Meta and would start developing its own iteration of the metaverse, a digital world where you could connect with other people, work, exchange information, spend time with friends, and do all sorts of cool activities. This was a huge announcement, since it was the first time that a large, global brand would delve into metaverse technology in such a straightforward manner. Following this, the general public's interest in the concept of metaverses spiked, quite noticeably. Some people are very excited about trying out this new form of technology and communication. Others, on the flip side, are very skeptical, especially since this is a concept explored by Facebook, a brand that, well, let's just say it doesn't have the best track record when it comes to user data collection and keeping user best interests in mind. No matter which camp you fall into, one thing seems to be certain. the metaverse will be an industry-changing innovation that will affect all of our lives. With crypto technology being intertwined with the idea of metaverses, this becomes an even more interesting concept to explore and familiarize yourself with. Wrapping this video up, I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video. I really hope that you've learned something, and most of all, I hope to see you in our next video.